Kilkelly, I'm 18 and 60, my dear and loving son John. Your good friend, the schoolmaster, Pat McNamara, so good as to write these words down. Your brothers have all gone to find work in England. The house is so empty and sad. And the crop of potatoes are sorely affected, a third to a half of them bad. And your sister Bridget and Patrick O'Donnell are to be married in June. Oh, your mother says not to work on the railroad, be sure to come on home soon. Kilkelly, I'm 18 and 17, my dear and loving son John. Hello to your missus and to your four children, may they grow healthy and strong. Oh, Michael has got in a wee bit of trouble, I'm sure he never will learn. And because of the dampness, there's no turf to speak of, and now we have nothing to burn. And Bridget is glad that she named the child for her, although she has six of her own. Oh, you say you found work, but you don't say what kind, or when you will be coming home. Kilkelly, Ireland, 18 and 18, Michael and John, my son. I'm sorry to give you the very sad news, your dear old mother's passed on. Oh, we buried her by a church in Kilkelly. Brothers and Bridget were there. Oh, you don't have to worry, she died very peaceful. Remember her in your prayers. And it's so good to hear that Michael's returning, with money he's sure to buy land. For the crop has been poor and the people are selling any price that they can. Kilkelly, Ireland, 18 and 19, my dear and loving son John. I am sure that I'm close on 18, it's 30 years since you're gone. Because of all of the money you send me, I'm still living out on my own. And Michael has built himself a fine house, and Bridget's children are grown. And thank you for sending your family picture, they're all fine women and men. And you say that you might even come for a visit, what joy to see you again. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1892, my brother John. Sorry I didn't write sooner to tell you that father's passed on. He was living with Bridget, she said he was cheerful and healthy right down to the end. And you should have seen him play with the grandchildren of Pat McNamara, your friend. And we bury him alongside of mother down at the Kilkelly church. Oh, he was a strong and a feisty old man, considering his life was so long. And it's funny how we kept talking about you. He called for you at the end. Oh, why don't you think about coming to visit? We'd all love to see you again. Kilkelly.